to Emery King and.
Mr. President, Mr. President, I understand that this is the first time Cedar Rapids has had a presidential visit since another great Republican, Dwight D. Eisenhower, came here and night press secretary down to Winterset, Iowa, which is the birthplace of John Wayne. And we were able to find one of the people who visited the picture of the Duke in his home. and the flag that we've given you today, because you are the one who has made us proud again. You notice that the flag is flying in front of his home. And you're the one who has made us proud again. The flag. Thank all of you so very much. Thank you.
Terrorist act that occurred this morning early in Beirut. The suicide attack against our embassy annex in East Beirut. I think it saddened all Americans, of course. And it's another painful push us out of doing what we must do throughout the world.
And I said, well, Reg, if you insist.
I know in this moment of anger and sorrow, our prayers are with those who are bereaved, and our commitment to peace remains firm. And I'm proud that I guess I don't have to tell any of you who that is. I've been following how things are going here and what your triumphs and travails have been.
So I've decided something. Air Force is, one is pretty big, and maybe if we all squeeze. Let's be sure of a practical philosophy. We believe that the way out of the economic morass of the 1970s was to let all the American people keep more of their hard-earned money.
We've got to do better. Here in Iowa, farmers are still feeling the effects of years and years of bad government policy and neglect. When the federal government wanted to make any more. Well, I know about your problems. As I see it, there is no America without the American farm. You know, grain agreement with the Soviets. Since last October, they have bought 23 million metric tons of grain. And as you may know, I approved raising the ceiling so they can buy an additional 10 million metric tons in the next year. By bringing down in
stretches across this country like a blanket with the Midwest safe and warm inside. Until the farmers recover then, our recovery is not complete. In the past few years, you've known droughts and other natural disasters, and we've tried to make sure that our programs provide a helping hand. You know, speaking of erosion is a major concern. And let me add that no one has helped us more in our efforts than Roger Jepson, your terrific senator, and Chuck Grassley, another hero of the cause. You know, it can be said that investing in the future is the most faithful act a man or woman can make. When you invest your hard work and your money, your effort, and your time, you show an extraordinary...
And then I had a tear on my cheek.
The presentation?
I'll give him a presentation, and then he's going to go to several other, three or four things before we
get the remarks. But we don't get that.
I was thinking as I came over, what would I say that would be unique or different on such an important occasion? And I recall that 30 years ago, 1954 to be exact, the President and I made a factory tour, much like we're going to make in a few minutes, in Baltimore, Maryland, a long time ago. But I can say with true sincerity that he was a gracious, sincere, and thoughtful man then, as he is today. And Mr. President, we're delighted that you're willing to come and share with us the dedication today of this new facility that we're very proud of. And what you're going to see is a factory of the latest technology dedicated to the manufacture of furniture systems to improve overall white collar productivity for our customers. We have, before you go in the factory, we have a 2-minute slide that we'd like to show you to give you a better idea of what you're going to see when we go on the factory floor. So if we could dim the lights, please, I'd like to show this.
That's good.
Dr. Kaplan, Sam, Dr. Dave.
Westinghouse Furniture Systems, integrating people and technology to manage change more productively.
We have 32 personalized workstations. Each station has an individual exhaust for those people who smoke or take the smoke. We have a question and answer button, so you don't have to raise your hand anymore. You just push the button and the light comes on. We have a computerized task light at each workstation, so as the lights are lowered, the computer turns the task light on and you can make your notes. And we have a 38-foot round turntable so that we can turn the audience to the focal point and not the opposite. And finally, we have a heating and cooling system here that is computer controlled that maximizes our energy efficiency. We at Westinghouse Furniture Systems don't think of this new facility as the workplace of the future, but feel it is more accurately reflected as the future of the workplace. Now that you have seen some of our high technology and some of our products, what we'd like to do is take you out into the factory and have you meet some of the people that make this product. So if you'll follow me, we'll take a walk out. Thank you.
Thank you.
Don't hide them. Don't hide them.
He's got new jeans on, right?
See, that's all right. He's with the White House. No, he's not. He's been assigned to. Well, that doesn't help. I know. I heard that.
Yeah, that's it.
Thank you. I don't blame you. I'm on his side. Of Reagan. Of course you don't have any idea.
Well, that's right.
I would rebel.
I'm gonna change tags.